Is this thing on? Welcome back to Big Mouth, and fancy seeing you here in June. A very welcome, my friends, and especially my enemies. Come in, sit down, no touching, I don't do the touching. And welcome to Friday's edition of the DC Movie and TV Daily. I'm Mick Minas. You can find me on Twitter at Movies TV Mad. Yes, I love those shameless plugs. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Our top DC movie story today, this Friday, is an awesome one. It and It Chapter 2 director confirms while he was doing the It Chapter 2 press call that he is indeed doing the Flash movie with Ezra Miller and says, yes, it's my next film. I'm going to give you some quotes. I'm going to read an article from Screen Rant because it's the first one I can find. Sometimes I love Screen Rant, sometimes I don't. But there you have it. We're going to be talking about that. And the Birds of Prey teaser trailer is incoming. I'm told either today or tomorrow, European time, because that's where I am. You're looking at from around 5 to 7 o'clock premiere time. So very, very, very exciting. Also, in DC TV news, Katie Lotz will be directing an episode of DC's Legends of Tomorrow. And with Daniel Panbaker directing an episode of The Flash, I'm asking, where are the male actors directing opportunities as well? We'll be talking about representation. Is it representation or is it revenge from SJW Hollywood? But first of all, this morning, it's massive. It's the news every DC and Flash fan wanted to hear. Andy Muschietti, or whatever his name is, It and It Chapter 2 director, is going to be directing the Flash movie. And here's the article from Screen Rant. It's director Andy Muschietti confirms Flash movie is his next project. I must admit, I was really excited hearing this yesterday. I mean, it's been a great couple of weeks for DC fans. The Sony-Disney split over Spider-Man was great news because I am a Spider-Man fan. It's not just getting some bad press for the MCU, and it is hilarious how this has happened. But we had the Joker final trailer, if you believe it's the final trailer. I don't. Red Band trailer incoming. Then we found out about the Birds of Prey trailer coming. And now this. Now, it's really funny, before I read this article, how people with an agenda going, oh, yeah, but the Flash movie has been in development hell for all these years. Not while Walter Hamada was running things, it wasn't. No. Whatever he sets out to do, he does. He's brilliant. He's a genius. I thank him that we're getting a Flash movie. And I do believe that Cyborg will share the stage. Because I think even as much as they talk about making great individual movies and standalone movies, they know that this must also be a great shared universe. So here's the article. Andy Muschietti officially confirms his involvement in directing the Flash solo film and says it'll be his next movie. The project has undergone by far the most creative hurdles and development hell, here we go, of any DCEU film, with multiple directors signing on and departing. The film's difficulties really came to a head earlier this year with reports of creative differences between leading man Ezra Miller and then directors John Francis Daley and Jonathan Goldstein, with the directing duo aiming for a light-hearted tone, while Miller favoured a darker approach. Ultimately, Miller took it upon himself to write his own script with comic book writer Grant Morrison. While rumours at the time indicated his days as the Scarlet Speedster were nearing an end, however, while Warner Brothers decided not to proceed with Miller and Morrison's screenplay, the studio elected to keep Miller in the role of Barry Allen, with Daley and Goldstein departing the project. Andy Muschietti, director of 2017's It and the upcoming sequel, It Chapter 2, would subsequently enter talks to direct the film. Christina Hodgson would also board as screenwriter, which is great news, by the way, with The Flash marking her third screenwriting role for a DCEU film, following the upcoming Birds of Prey and the in-development Batgirl. While Muschietti had previously tiptoed around questions about The Flash at San Diego Comic-Con in 2019. This marks the director's first public confirmation of this involvement in the film. The topic of The Flash came up during an interview with Fandango as part of the promotional tour for It Chapter 2. When asked by correspondent Nikki Novak if he would indeed be directing The Flash, Machete matter-of-factly replied, "Yup." Machete further explained how he was drawn to the project, stating, "What captivated me about The Flash is the human drama in it," he elaborated. "The human feelings and emotions at play in the drama of it were the factors that enticed him to sign on to direct. However, fans of Machete's work on the It movie shouldn't necessarily hold their breath for the film to carry a similar horror movie feel." As Machete explained, "I can't promise that there will be any horror elements in it, really, but it's a beautiful human story." While The Flash has undergone the most birthing pains of any DC film, Machete's comments will doubtlessly come as a welcome sign to fans that the film may finally break free of its development purgatory. It's happening, people, it's happening. And enter active production. Furthermore, while Machete's confirmation of his own involvement doesn't directly address Miller's continued tenure as Barry Allen, it also signals the director's intent of taking the film in the direction that Miller had aimed for, with his and Morrison's screenplay. There's still a lot of unknowns at play with The Flash, but at the very least, fans can take comfort that the ball finally seems to be rolling for the fastest man alive. Brilliant article, well said, apart from the doubts it puts in. Ezra Miller is The Flash. Ezra Miller and Grant Morrison's screenplay will be adapted by Hodgson. There is no question about that, or Miller would have walked. This is what the threat was. Miller said, "I cannot be involved with what Goldstein and Daly want to do. They're great directors. I love what they've done in the past. But please, you cannot Marvelize this film." What I think happened when Walter Hamada took over, they were already in place, or maybe he put them. I don't think he put them in place, by the way. I think that was Kevin Sugihara. And I think they looked at it, and he probably went to Walter Hamada and said, "Listen, I can't be involved with this." And I think Walter Hamada quickly agreed. And what Walter Hamada did, he put one of his top writers, Hodgson, in the role of adapting his and Grant Morrison's screenplay. And that's brilliant. This is so exciting. Because last night when I heard this, I just thought, wow, with what they're doing with Joker, and now this being confirmed, it's absolutely brilliant news. And I'm so excited. 6 movies being filmed for DC movies for the DCEU next year. Well, we think they're all DCEU movies. You know what? It absolutely would not surprise me if the Batman and the Joker movie wasn't in the same universe. We've been told by so many sources that the Batman is set in the 90s, right? So let's just say Joker movie is set in the 80s. So that would be 10 years. So basically Joaquin's Joker would be 10 years older. It could kind of work. Who knows? Who knows? We were told the Joker movie is a standalone movie. Now Todd Phillips is telling us he's up for a sequel, as long as Joaquin Phoenix is up for a sequel as well. They know that this film is going to hit big. It's going to change what Hollywood and Warner Brothers want to do with DC movies. That's extremely, very, very exciting. Very. Now, moving on to this incoming Birds of Prey trailer. We have heard so many things about Birds of Prey. Grace Randolph had this so-called scoop about what the plot was going to be. She made it sound like a bad thing. I don't think so. And isn't it hilarious watching someone like Grace Randolph being oozing with excitement over the Joker movie trailer when weeks ago she said, "I wish DC could be like Marvel with an interconnected universe." But then she's oozing excitement over a standalone DC movie. These people are hypocrites. And it doesn't matter if they... Look, SJW pundits are going to come at Joker movie hard. But the first time, their thoughts and feelings will be irrelevant, because highbrow critics and highbrow people are going to protect this fantastic movie. So, yeah, I think it's absolutely amazing. Now, moving on to Birds of Prey, I can't wait to see this teaser trailer. The other day, BatmanNews.com saying, don't expect to see too much. No, we don't expect to see the whole film. I'm expecting a trailer of 30 seconds to a minute, but the Joker movie teaser trailer was about 2 minutes and 42 seconds, yes, or around 37 seconds. So this could be a long one. I hope so, but whatever we get, we're finally going to see something. And that's really, really exciting. But there's more rumours about DCEU marketing. We're getting more posters and official artwork from Wonder Woman 1984, which will be the biggest hit of 2020. I shag you not. I measure you not. And I believe we're going to get a trailer in September. Yes, I believe we're going to get a trailer in September. So not only have we had Joker movie final trailer, I keep on doing that because I don't believe it's the final trailer, we're definitely getting the Birds of Prey teaser trailer any day now. And if in September we get the Wonder Woman 1984 trailer, wow, how exciting is that? As I say, it's great to be a DC movie fan right now. I don't care what people with agendas say. Yes, I love Man of Steel and Batman v Superman, but just because Zack isn't involved anymore and we haven't got the Snyder Cut yet, I'm not going to bite my nose off to spite my face. I love DC. I love DC movies. Bring it on. Now let's move on to DC TV. So we know Danielle Panabaker, right, is getting to direct a Flash episode, right? She plays Killer Frost. Katie Lotz, right, is actually getting to direct a DC's Legends of Tomorrow episode. Now, this is a great opportunity for both of these actors. They're really talented people and deserve their opportunity. Please do not misunderstand me. But where are the opportunities for the male actors to direct too? The more I look at SJW Hollywood, the more it's looking like they're not interested in representation. They're interested in revenge, because otherwise the male actors will be getting opportunities. You're going to tell me, yeah, but men have had opportunities for years. That means they don't deserve to have equality right now. This is supposed to be the era of equality. So good luck to Katie Lotz and Daniel Panabaker, right? But I want to see the male actors getting a fair crack of the whip as well. And Brandon Ralph leaves, so that reduces the male roll call on DC's Legends of Tomorrow as well. Again, that's not equality, that's revenge. But if it turns out that Brandon is actually going to play a full-time role in a Superman TV show, then I will apologise to Greg Berlanti and everyone involved, because I love Superman and he should be on our TV screens every week, and he should have a movie every 2 years, and he should cameo in other DCEU movies as well. In other news, when we go back to the Joker, Todd Phillips, the director of the Joker film and the co-writer, has said it took him a year to persuade Warner Brothers to actually make Joker an R-rated film. Now, this isn't a big shock, because studios are businesses and they want as many consumers to eat up their content as possible. And what an R rating does, it takes a lot of butts out of the seats. But if you get enough adults involved, and let's not forget that cinemas let underage people watch these films. Come on, we all know where the bodies are buried here. So this, look, I think this is an interesting film in the sense of it being, now a lot of people, I kind of said it could make $1 billion. I think it's possible. A lot of you people comment in the comments down below don't believe that's possible. I do. If Venom made around 800 million, then how much is a much anticipated Joker movie going to make? Everybody knows the Joker. Heath Ledger put the Joker up there even higher. People are going to be interested. I think this could make just under or just about $1 billion. I know you think I'm crazy. We shall see. But this film is going to hit big. Also, when the Joker movie, we heard it was in development, we were told about a DC Black Label, a shadow of the comic DC Comics Black Label, which is kind of rebranded Vertigo. So Vertigo and its content is still there, but it's within the Black Label. A very, very good idea. right? Vertigo was great quality. A shame they kind of changed what they were doing with it, but still, Vertigo still exists. Anyway, right, when he first pitched the idea of a DC Black Label, Warner Brothers said, just make this movie. Let's forget about the Black Label and let's make this film and see how we get on. In other words, if this film makes enough money and does what they want it to do, which it will, a DC Black Label is incoming. We're going to get more and more movies. So it's not that Warner Brothers have said we don't want to do it, but for Christ's sake, let's not announce a Black Label, then Joker movie flops, and then we look like idiots again. So Warner Brothers are really learning their lesson. I think it's more Walter Hamada than Warner Brothers. It's his department. He's in charge of it. So I think it's going to happen, but they're going to see what happens with Joker. Joker is going to be a massive, massive success. So are you excited about confirmation that Andy Muschietti will be directing the Flash movie starring Ezra Miller? I am. Do you think that Cyborg will be in this movie? I think he will. And I think it will be very exciting once that's announced. Are you excited for the Birds of Prey trailer? I am. Do you think it's an exciting time, as I do, for DC movies now with Walter Hamada at the helm? Or are you keeping to your agenda? No Snyder, no party. As much as I love Zack, I can't do that. I'm a passionate DC fan, and I'm so excited. Bring on the Joker movie, bring on the Birds of Prey trailer, the Woman 1984 trailer. It's a great time to be alive. It's a great time to be a DC fan. Be positive. Taking that DC air, a new era of cinema is coming.